So today we'll be seeing how to automatically change the product and the category attributes to a selected store view using the Google Translator. Earlier, as we know that whenever a customer selected any store view other than the default one, the category and the product name didn't get translated as per the selected store view. So now using the Magento 2 Multi-Vendor Marketplace Catalog Translation plugin, the customers can select any of the store views and the entire store language will be translated accordingly. Kindly note that this particular plugin is an add-on to the Magento 2 Multi-Vendor Marketplace by Webpool. So you'll have to have that particular plugin first and then you can make use of this add-on. Apart from that, you should also get the API key from the Google Translation Services, and that needs to be set up in the admin configuration panel. Apart from that, this particular plugin also translates the vendor product attributes completely. So before proceeding further and showing you the rest of the workflow of this particular plugin, please do subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to receive the latest updates from our end. And if you find this particular video helpful, then do kindly give it a thumbs up. So right now you can see that I've chosen the normal store view and everything here is in English. So here you can see that under the gears we have the bags, and here is the name of the product, that's the Crown Summit Backpack. Now if I as a customer change the store view by tapping on the other store view there, you can see that the name of the product, label for the add to cart button, and here the category along with the name of the product is translated in Arabic itself. And if I scroll down here, we can see the details also being translated into Arabic, the review options being translated into Arabic, product names being translated into Arabic language. So if I go to one of the products like this product, then we'll be able to see the same on the product page there as well. It would be translated into the other store view language according to that itself. So you can see that it's in Arabic right now. Now if I show you, if I go to the gears, here I have set up the the second level as in Arabic. It has also been translated, so you can translate the category names or the subcategory names as well. And now if I choose the other store view, that's the default or the other store view, it would then be translated back into the normal store language for that particular store view. And here you can see that I've translated it, and in a few seconds it would be translated back into the default language, that's the English language, that is for the Webpool test store. And for the Arabic one, and I had selected the test store. Now if I go to the gears icon, a gears menu option, here you can see that now the bags sub menu option for the gears is in English again. So accordingly you can change the store view, and the entire store view changes according to the language of that particular store view. So now if I choose my test store view again, and after that you'll be able to see the change in the view there. So what happens is that as soon as we change the store according to the store language, the rest of the things are basically being translated into that particular language, as you can see in the Arabic language here. So this is for English to Arabic translation that we have shown you as an example there. Now let's hop on to the admin backend panel and let's see how the admin can configure this particular plugin from the admin backend panel first. So for that, let's hop on to the admin backend panel now. So I've logged into the admin backend panel. So I'll first be showing you the initial configuration. So for that, we need to navigate through stores and then configuration. And I'll also be showing you how the translation can be done for the existing products and categories. And apart from that, how we can manually go to the category translation and the product translation as well. So right now we're just checking the backend configuration there. And here on the configuration page under the Webpool block, we'll go to the marketplace, and there we'll navigate to the marketplace catalog translation. And here we have four different options. Here's the API key for the Google translation there. So you need to get that first, and then you have to enter it here within this particular section. So you shouldn't be having an account there. And thereafter only you can get the API key. Kindly check the user guide for more details about how to get the API key. So here you can enable the translations by choosing a yes. Otherwise choose no to disable the enable translations. You can enable the product translations by choosing a yes, and you can also enable the category translations by choosing a yes option for the marketplace catalog translation. Thereafter, just tap on the save configuration button and we are done configuring the initial configurations there. Now let me show you how we can do the translation for the existing products and categories. So for that, I'll just take you to the user guide for a moment. So here you need to just run this particular command, that's php bin /magento update translation category, and this command is used to translate the already existing old categories as per the chosen store view. The same goes for the run command for the existing product translation. So this command here is used to translate the already existing old products as per the chosen store view. So this was about how we can translate the language there according to the store view for the existing products and categories. Now let me take you to the category section first, and then we'll be checking out the product edit page as well. So right now you can see that here we have the gear category, and under that we have the bags. So I've set up the configuration for the bags there. So according to the store we've chosen, the language would be changed here as well. So if I choose the test store view, let's tap OK on the prompt. As soon as the page refreshes, the bags would be translated into the Arabic language itself. So here at the top as well, you can see the name has been changed to the respective language there. And here as well, you can see the change for the Arabic language. Here the category name has automatically changed, as you've just seen the same. Now the same goes for the product. So if I go to the products by navigating through catalog and products, I've just chosen this arrival field messenger bag. So I'll just tap on that, the edit link under the actions column. Now depending upon the store view, the language would be chosen. Right now we have all store view. Let me choose test store view. Let's tap OK on the prompt there before changing the store view. And now according to the store view, you can see that the product name has been automatically changed into the selected store view, that's the test store view. The same had been shown to you at the storefront test store view. It is in Arabic. Now if I go for the Whirlpool other store view, that's the basic one, then the language would be translated into the English language. So here you can see that now it's in the English language there. And if I go ahead and choose the test store view, the particular details of the product and the categories would be changed into the Arabic language there. So if I go here to the gears icon, it's in English right now. And now if I choose the test store view, and now there will be the translation itself, as you can see, for the subcategory as well. You can see the translation has worked there. And here as well, if I scroll down, you can see the category name for the is visible here, the selected categories and the other language according to the store view language that the customer has chosen. So yes, that was much about the plugin itself. That's the Magento 2 Marketplace Catalog Translation plugin. And if you still have any questions, queries, suggestions or requirements, then kindly do get back to us at support@webcool.com, raiseaticket@webcool.us.com. You can also contact us through https://www.webcool.com/contact. And if you find this particular video helpful, then do kindly give it a thumbs up. And lastly, thanks for watching this video and have a great day.